a version of I Gave My Love a Cherry, collected from a lady named Margaret Donovan in St. Helens, Kentucky, in 1918. I gave my love a cherry that has no skin. I gave my love a chicken that has no bone. I gave my love a story that has no end. I gave my love a baby with no crying. How can there be a cherry that has no stone? How can there be a chicken that has no
Bellos Excelsior, which means a large oblong dulcimer.
The story behind it is just as important, because he ordered some Galax cases and they sent them the wrong size, but they didn't want them back, so he said, well, I'll just have to make something that fits these cases.
So I just came up with it, so it's like, okay, so here it is. Okay, look at the thing that's real.
Thank you. You want me to do it slow and then do it a little bit faster? Okay.
Here we go. This is a tune I made up of a tune that you would recognize, but for the Lang-a-Lang.
Lang-a-Lang, the Lang-a-Lang, in the Northland, the mighty Northland, a Lang-a-Lang plays tonight. In the the mighty Northland, the Lang-a-Lang plays tonight. Ooh, ooh, Lang-a-Lang. Ooh, ooh, Lang-a-Lang.
So, but,
Jethro Tull.
the stormy for staying out all night. Papa, he'll uphold me, uphold me, uphold me. Papa, he'll uphold me, say it done just right.
Do anything. You sing those two songs, then you, those two verses, then you sing anything else. And this is directly from Washington Square Park to you. This is, let's see. I have to find myself here. Who's gonna shoot your pretty little foot? Who's gonna go out your house?
Such a lover. actually is quite clever. With an ounce of gold may not be found in this wide world all over. Oh, daughter dear, I am surprised at your infatuation. But think of having Billy Grimes, it would be ruination. Oh, daughter dear, I did not hear your last remark quite clearly, but Billy is a nice young man and no doubt loves you dearly.
At the University of Charleston, and one of my favorite activities is to sing chemistry songs with my chemistry students. Now, how many of you have taken chemistry? Okay, hold your hands up. Keep your hands up. How many of you have sung chemistry songs? So it's kind of a new concept, but we have a good time with it, and we have a good time with the students, and it's just a lot of fun. And I have a questionnaire that I put at the end of each test that says, you know, how can we make the class better? How can we better prepare you for the test? But how can we make the class better? More singing. More singing. More singing. And I figure it's because if I'm up there singing and stuff, it's less time that they've got to take notes and write stuff down. That's the real reason. That's the real reason. Okay, so this is a fun little song. This is by Michael Offutt, who's a singer-songwriter, retired chemistry teacher from Chicago area, and he has a couple of CDs out of all chemistry songs, and one on physics, and so he is just, it's just awesome, you know, it's just awesome. And the songs, I love them because they're very, very musical and catchy, but they also teach concepts. They also teach concepts, and so it's they're a lot of fun. And the kids on the test said, oh, yeah, I'm glad you said, that was in your song. That was in the song that you did. Yeah. So here's a little song about acids and bases, okay? And you're all up on your acids and bases, right? So we're going to learn a little bit about acids and bases here. Oh, let's see. Acids and bases have two different faces, two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry. Let's sing that together. Acids and bases have two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry. First thing you gotta get straight in your head, acids turn blue litmus paper to red. They react with metals with awesome power. They neutralize bases and they taste real sour. Bases are different from acids, it's true. Bases turn red litmus paper to blue. They neutralize acids, feel slippery on the skin, taste sort of bitter and are called alkaline. Here we go! Acids and bases have two different faces, two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry. Well, there's even more to this wonderful tale, something we call a pH scale. It numbers from 0 up to 14. Those are powers of 10 if you know what I mean. When the pH is 7, then it's the case the solution is neither acid or base. Less than 7, it's an acid, we say. More than 7, it's a base. All the way! Acids and bases have two different bases, two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry. Let me hear you. Bases and bases, why should you care? Because acids and bases are everywhere. You put them on salads and they get in the rain. They settle your tummy and they clean out your drain. So the next time you're sitting under some shade and you're sipping a glass full of real lemonade, you'll notice a sour taste and think in your head, I bet it turns blue in this paper to red. Acids and bases have two different faces, two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry. Let me hear you. hear ya!
Passes and faces have two different faces, two different personalities, and you gotta find out what they're all about if you wanna learn chemistry.
Thank you. competition.
Ow!
Mike Mudhole. Their names are Raymond and Ryla. The one in the water there is Ryla. And Raymond is laying back in the shade. The breed that our pigs are is Osceola Island. The Osceola Island pig is a very rare pig. It's the kind of pig George Washington knows.
Okay, so all these are George Washington stock, or?
Currently not. Let's see. Their father came from Bedford County.
Yeah, he likes to get in there.
Sure, sweet pigs.
No problem. All right, we'll see y'all later.
Bye.
Hello. Oh, look at the little sheep. Mm-hmm. Will they come to you?
Maybe.
Sheep, sheep. Sheep, sheep. Sheep, sheep. Sheep, sheep. Come on out.
They're probably not going to walk out of the shade.
Yeah.
You can walk up there if you don't mind.
Yeah, because they're hot with it.
She's getting a little dirty.
Okay. So our donkey's name is Clara.
Clara.
And a donkey would not have actually been likely to have been in this area in 1800, which is our time period. Donkeys were gifted to George Washington in the late 1790s, so they probably wouldn't have been in this area by 1800. But we have problems with predators, so the donkey is here as a protection animal for the sheep. Come here, Clara. You look so nice. You had a brushing yesterday, didn't you?